You will have to excuse the way I've got this set up to do this. Day one started at Burnt Mill Bridge and ended up at this campsite. Also, the Sheltowee Trace maps that I have, although they have the new section map, they don't actually have the new section trail, so you can't just pull the map out and look at it. Then I noticed today, wearing my Polar V800 GPS watch and my Garmin 62SC, along with the trail notes, thru-hiker trail notes book that I bought, none of the mileages match up between the three items. So you're just kind of left to guess where you're at. So outside of that, I am beat. I'm super exhausted. I burned around 8,200 and some calories. By the time I actually got to camp, it was dark. So I kind of half-assed hung my bear bag and set my tarp up. And built a small fire, which I usually never do. Let me show you the small fire. Small fire. So I'm kind of hoping that day two goes better. And we'll find out tomorrow. This goes out to Shug, who I've watched lots of his videos, and for over 2 years now, maybe 3 years, every time I set up or pack camp, I always hear Shug saying, on the knot, not on the toggle, on the knot, not on the toggle. How hikers eat. I'm gonna try to do this with one hand. How hikers eat who have overslept. This is really a two-hand operation. came from down there and up these rocks, which is about 12 feet or so, and then up another 6 feet over to this sketchy cable system. This is going to be my journal for day two. Looking over the official thru-hiker guide. The camp that I was at on day one was at 12.03 trail miles. And yesterday my GPS on my Garmin 62SC and then plus my watch both said I did around 16 miles. Either way, I reset everything, and for the first mile or two today I literally held this and validated each thing down through here, which made it easier to know where I was at. But I did not get as many trail miles today. So right now, I am at trail mile in the book. Give me just a minute to find it. .76, which means that I did 7.73 today. My legs are really sore. I tried to eat better and still having issues with shortages of water. The areas that are marked as water sources, most of them are dried up, and it's kind of aggravating. Matter of fact, the way that I found this site was that the site before that I was going to camp at, the water was really brackish. There was water there, it was about an inch deep, and I put some in my 1 liter smart water bottle, and it literally smelled like sewage water. It was nasty. So I dumped it out and come a little ways farther to here, maybe a mile, mile and a half. So that's the problem I'm running into. You get a water source and then for the next 4 or 5 are bone dry. It makes it really hard. It seems like when I don't need water, there's plenty of water sources. And an example is the Cumberland River isn't listed as a good water source, but I literally run out of water as soon as I went across that ONW bridge. So just 500 feet down through there, run out of water. I went maybe another mile and started to get a headache. Well, that's the other thing too. So yesterday the temperatures, my cell phone was showing yesterday 88 degrees. And then today my cell phone was showing a temperature of 86 degrees. Mind you, this is the last week of September when normally it's 70s. So I think either tomorrow or Tuesday the temperature is supposed to be closer to normal. And that'll help out a lot with the water situation because I won't require as much water. So part of the reason of the water is I'm consuming more because it's so hot outside. So once the weather's cooler, I'll probably consume less. So I now have 2 liters of filtered water in my bladder, and I have, I already cooked dinner, which is sitting here, waiting to reconstitute. And then I have over there 2 more nearly full 1 liter bottles that still need filtered. So this is where I'm making camp. Like I said, it's at 19.76 trail miles. 19.76 trail miles. And try to get to bed early. I don't think I'm going to do a fire tonight. And hopefully when I wake up, my legs are not as sore. So, that's all. this is day three. So I got up about 6. I got daylight about 7. Met a girl with an EpiPen and a dog named Molly. Introduced her to the Sawyer Builder. And I had breakfast, did 4 Advil. Took off around 9:30 or so. Felt really good today. 11.5 GPS miles, but only 9.76 trail miles. I ended up at Cherit Lodge. It was about 4:30 p.m. when I got here, and it looked like it was going to start raining, so I just kind of felt spent, and I went ahead and got a day use area. The fee was $11. I got a Dr. Pepper and a Snickers also. Oh, that was the other thing. So I haven't really had much of an appetite today. I had breakfast and a few Slim Jims and a few bit of honeys and a Snickers, and that's about it. So I'm hoping to turn in a little early tonight and get rested up. Trail legs still haven't kicked in. So right now I'm at about 30 miles, give or take. So averaging 10 miles a day. Trail miles, not GPS miles. 10 miles a day, trail miles. I estimated that I had 12 hours of daylight, and I've really only got 10 hours hiking. By the time you take out lunches and breaks, and you know, the only way to get around it to get a full 12 hours would be to get up at 6, cook breakfast in the dark, hit the trail at 7, hike with no rest or breaks until 7 p.m., and then set up camp and cook in the dark, which doesn't sound like fun. So I really need to increase my speed. But my legs are really sore, so that's where I stand. Today has been a day of enter and leave horse trails. I enter a horse trail, so just on the other side of that sign right there, I come off a trail, and I was on the horse trail for 20 yards. Now I leave the horse trail, and you wait and see. It'll be like 20 yards, and then back on the horse trail for 20 yards or something. It is like the craziest thing ever. I go, why in the hell are you rerouting this? Like, I'm looking over at the horse trail. The horse trail looks okay. Why couldn't I just stay on the friggin' horse trail? And what the hell? Right there's the horse trail. See, I know a lot of people are going to be saying, where are all the cool pictures and the cool scenery and the cliffs and the mountains? And believe it or not, you are looking down 99% of the time. You occasionally look up, try to find out where you're at. So am I still on the trail? It kind of looks like I am. I don't see any blazes, which is not unusual. This kind of looks like a trail. The leaves are crunchy. There's some good sticks on the ground. And basically that's what you do pretty much this whole hike. Oh, there's actually a blaze. Holy shit. I'm excited. I'm going in the right direction. I should take out my GPS and take a picture of it, because they are few and far between. This one's even upside down. I wasn't able to do a day 4 trail log video because the battery went dead in my camera. So now that the battery is charged up, it is now mid-afternoon, 2 p.m. on day 5. I'm doing day 4's trail log. I actually did GPS miles around 22. I'll have to look at the GPS data when I get home because the battery also went dead in my watch and on my GPS and in the camera and in my phone. How's that for sweet? So day 4. Day 4 I did a lot of trail miles. I started at Chariot Lodge and ended at Davies Road. I did 22 miles on 2 liters of water. Not by choice. The reason being that every water source between Chariot Lodge and Davies Road, including the next one after that, bone dry. Actually, the one after Davies had water, but it looked really nasty. So, I ended up getting water. So here's what happened. At about, I don't know, 6 p.m., I realized that I'd probably have to night hike. So I took my pack off, got my headlamp out, got it ready for when it got dark. My goal was to make it to the next water source, which was the one past Davies Road. So I kicked in high gear and just kind of went through the pain and hiked. Made it to Davies Road just as it's, you know, really time to get the headlamp out. So I get the headlamp out, put it on, hike down to where the creek's at. Take a look at it. Not interested in the water that was there. It was kind of brackish smelling. Had a lot of leaves in it. Originally I was going to camp on the bridge. I took my chair out, sat on the chair on the bridge, put my Frog Togs poncho over top of me to, you know, shed off any moisture dew from the night, and also to keep in some body heat. And for whatever reason, I decided 15-20 minutes later to go back to Davies Road. I nearly called it quits. I ain't gonna joke. The struggling to find water the whole trip has been horrible. So for 12 miles, day four, I was without water because I ran out 10 miles in. 2 liters of water, 10 miles, about. And then spent 12 miles trying to find water. I never did find water. So I go back to Davies Road from the bridge, and I'm like, fuck it. I'm sure the game wardens and game service don't permit you to camp there, but I'm going to camp there anyway. So at the intersection of Sheltowee Trace and Davies Road, there were two trees just far enough apart for me to put my hammock. I pitched it at like 9:30 at night. No sooner than I laid down, I heard a vehicle coming. And it turned off before it got to me. So I didn't have water for food. I didn't have water to drink. I was dehydrated. Like when I peed, it burned, like that dehydrated. My lips were dry. They're actually still dry today. My lips were dry. My muscles were extremely sore from dehydration. I nearly was gonna call it quits. I had cell phone service. I could have easily just texted my support crew, my sister, and said, come and get me. But part of the thing about long distance hiking is mental toughness. Really, part of the thing about life in general is mental toughness. You can't just give up at every opportunity that you don't feel like moving forward. You have to keep going. So I decided to sleep on it and see what happened. And at about 6:30 in the morning, I hear a vehicle coming. And I see flashing lights, and I'm thinking, oh God, here comes the cops or something. I don't know what it was. It drove past me. I assume they didn't even hear me or didn't even see me. I don't know how they could, and I was 5 feet off the side of the road. Probably someone who's drove that road a million times and just totally didn't see me. You know, if you think about it, if you drive the same route every day, like to work, there's shit that will change that you don't notice, and then there's shit that will change you do notice. So my guess is the guy's looking to the right, I was on the left, or maybe he just saw me and didn't care. But finally, about So I have my alarm set for 6:45 every morning, so I can get up, try to get breakfast in me and coffee, and out by 7 or 7:15. But I was still in that, should I call it, mood. So I laid in the hammock till about 7:30. Then I got up, because I don't have any water for coffee or breakfast. I knew the next place didn't have water. It was like a mile away or 8/10 of a mile away. God only knows where I was going to find water at. But I decided that I was going to push on. Can't give up. And I don't know where it was at. I finally got water. The good thing was it was cool. It much cooler night. I was in my had my underquilt and top quilt. The top quilt's rated at 40 degrees. The underquilt is 40 degrees plus 2 ounces of overstuff, so I don't know, 30 degrees maybe on it. I got woke up 2 or 3 times in the middle of the night, cold. That morning was cold when I finally did get out of the hammock. So the first hour or two of my hike was mostly to stay warm once I did finally get going. But I finally found water and I wasn't sweating much, so that was good. And then I looked at the trail notes and it was basically saying that there was going to be good water sources like every 15 feet for the next 20 miles, which really meant there would be a good water source once every 6 miles if you didn't pass it by without seeing it. So I took my chances, and when I found a water source, I put 1 liter in the bladder, 1 liter in my smart water bottle in case that I decided to have breakfast, which I never did, and carried on. Amazingly, I made it to the intersection of where the Sheltowee Trace Spur Trail now goes to Pickett State Park. I've done this a couple of times. This is known as foot maintenance. Your feet is like your car, and foot maintenance is like changing the oil in your car. So you basically use your body to smack out as much dust out of your 5-day-old socks that you can, and any kind of sticks or briars or anything else. Oh, but we aren't done, because we have to turn the sock inside out and do the at that side too. the briars are the ones that you really have to watch for, because they don't show up very good, but they get embedded in your sock and you feel them when you're walking with a rubbing feeling. They do things like this. Scratches on the legs from same said briars. But if they get in your sock, they do this. And of course, 5 day old unwashed feet. And not to be too sickening to you, but that also means 5 day old toe jam. You get to clean out with your fingers. Not really. I try to do this every day or two, so. Still, 2 days of toe jam. Pretty fucking nasty. I'm sure I'm going to have to edit that out. Feet maintenance, very important for hiking. Long distance hiking. If you're just doing a weekend hike or a week long hike or car camping, not a big deal. But if you're doing long distance hiking, it's pretty urgent that you take care of your feet. I've twisted this ankle twice. And it's been a little sore today. So along with feet care goes shoe care. You're basically emptying out any crap that's in there. And then once you get the loose stuff out, stick your hands down in there and rub them around to get the stuff loosened up that's already dried and turned into a chalk. You probably heard it. I heard it. My Brooks Cascadia. I really like these shoes. I think these are 10s. Brooks Cascadia 10, I think. I've got the Dr. Soles Active Series insoles installed. I've always had really good luck with. But I think the Dr. Soles insoles went out. Or so into this hike. They've been bothering my feet quite a bit. Or the trail's been bothering my feet quite a bit, which is really unusual because I hike a lot. I don't know why. The right leg does not look near as bad as the left leg. I think a bear tried to get me and I just didn't notice it. Maybe that's what it is. Muscles in my legs are extremely sore. So. That's a foot maintenance.
There's either a deer or a bear right up there. I think it was a deer. I don't think a bear would come around me speaking like this.
So that's the other thing. So I've seen bear scat throughout Tennessee, and now I'm in Kentucky, 8 or 9 miles from the border. And I've seen a lot of bear scat today, and I've seen a lot of bear markings on the trees where they mark, the males mark their height to set up their territories on the trees, and I've taken a couple pictures of that stuff. So I am definitely in bear territory. So in Tennessee, I didn't hardly see any bear sign, but about the time I got close to the Kentucky border, from there on, I've seen a lot of bear signs. I'm pretty certain that was a deer, though. It went Hey, deer. Hey, deer. Hey, deer. Hey, deer. Hey, deer. And there we have the answer. It's a deer, for sure. Hi, deer. Oh well, so that's how day four is going. Day four was not very good. Day five has been a little bit better. Slower on the trail miles. And I'm going to pack up and get out of here while animals are looking at me like I'm crazy. So, this is kind of related to day four. So the deer showing up probably was at a really good time. If you ever ask for a sign to keep going, that was my sign. Day five, a little early. Let me show you this. Where I'm at now. I don't know if you can tell. Let's just walk. And let me show you what I'm faced with today on day five. I'm actually running next to a creek, so water, although I hear it, there's not many opportunities to get close to it. Steep banks. I did actually find one place I got water. But planning this hike in the fall, on day five, actually day four, maybe day three, I started to realize it, but today especially, day five. Planning this hike in the fall was maybe not the greatest idea. It hasn't rained in forever, so that explains the water sources being low. The leaves are falling, which camouflages the ground. And if I wasn't an experienced hiker and also an experienced hunter and trapper, I probably would not be able to find this trail a lot of times. I mean, can you tell where the trail is? If you look down, it looks like just the rest of the ground. There are some places that I have to just stop and look around and hope and pray I can find a trail marker, which are few and far between, as I've mentioned before. And just like where is the trail? That's it for now. massive waterfall is barely putting out any water. You can see the little bit there-ish. This is where, unfortunately, it has to end. I rolled an ankle, and right away my ITB said, we're done. Right now, I just came from this direction. And so, GPS trail miles for today is 1320. The last mile or two really took me a long time. Let's see if I can recall this off of memory. It was after the large waterfall, and then there's another part where you're going past some like boulders and overhangs and things, and I had like a few steps going down. You can actually kind of see where mud on my leg from the fall.